Welcome to another episode of This Is My Architecture. Today I have here with me Josh from Spot.io by NetApp. Hi Josh.
Hi.
So Josh, tell me a little bit more about Spot.io.
Yeah, so Spot.io is an automation provider and we help customers leverage Spot instances to save up to 90% in the cloud.
Oh, so you make it even easier to use Spot instances.
That's correct.
Can we dive into how you do that?
Yeah. So we do that by leveraging CloudFormation. When our customer signs up for our SaaS service, they'll deploy a CloudFormation template in their environment that will deploy an IAM policy and an IAM role with an external ID so that only our SaaS layer can leverage that cross-account IAM role.
See. So as a SaaS provider, you use the IAM role to only have access to what in their customer environment?
Yeah, so using IAM, our data collectors that are running on Spot instances, our data collectors can describe EC2 instances, autoscaling groups, containerized workloads in their environment. And then using that information, we collect that and our customers can then begin using our services.
Mm-hmm. And what kind of, so you collect all data about the infrastructure environment. How do you do that collection?
Yeah, so using our data collector, we'll collect data. We collect 2 billion data points a day, and we store that data in Aurora. So our data comes in from the data collectors and then goes into Aurora.
I see. And what other kind of data do you use to actually do that prediction?
Yeah, so we're actively monitoring all the AWS regions and availability zones and all the Spot capacity pools in real time. We're collecting that data, storing it in Aurora, and then using SageMaker to analyze that data and use machine learning models to predict when Spot instances are going to be interrupted.
When you have that prediction of Spot instances, so what happened to your customer's infrastructure?
Yeah, so in the event that we do predict an interruption, which we can predict 1 hour in advance with 85% accuracy, when we can make a prediction that there's gonna be a Spot interruption, we'll leverage that cross-account IAM role and replace the Spot instance for the customer. So leveraging IAM, we can then help our customers use EKS and then replace these Spot instances in their worker nodes proactively.
So if you're replacing those worker instances automatically, then what are your customers, how your customers interact with your SaaS platform?
Yeah, so customers interact with our SaaS platform via our SaaS tool. They can also deploy services in AWS using CloudFormation, our infrastructure as code.
I see that you're doing this for your customers. Do you have a lot of customers that are using this solution?
Yeah, we have thousands of customers today in AWS.
And how do you manage that amount of customers in your SaaS environment?
Yeah, we scale using Aurora, SageMaker, and EKS. We love AWS fully managed services. When we first began, we ran MySQL on EC2, and we ran Kubernetes on EC2, and we even had machine learning models on EC2. But as we growed, we noticed that we couldn't scale as fast. But using these fully managed services with AWS, we can grow quicker.
I see. You have your SaaS platform. You're making it even easier to use Spot instances while still maintaining security for your customers. And you're doing all of this seamlessly. Your customer basically just have to worry about the development of their workload.
That's correct. Customers just deploy pods into their Kubernetes workload and we'll scale the environment for them.
Great. I love your architectures. Thank you so much for sharing this with us.
Thank you.
And thank you for watching another episode of This Is My Architecture.